Commodore's keeping up with you. In a world of fun and fantasy, and ever-changing views, and computer terminology, Commodore reviews. Are you keeping up with the Commodore? 'Cause the Commodore's keeping up with you. G'day there everyone, welcome to Sony Vegas Zen Tips number 12. Today I'm going to show you some different techniques for downloading your camera's video and audio images. What you just saw was a fantastic ad on Australian TV from 1985 for the legendary Commodore 64. This was my family's first computer and a lot of Australian homes bought one of these at the time. However, if you were a rich kid, you probably had an Apple II instead. The reason why I just showed you that, besides getting high on 1985, is because the Commodore 64 had a whopping 64 kilobytes of memory. Now have a look at this little sucker. A little SDXC memory card. This can store over 1 million times more data than what was possible in those first home computers. Now I'm going to show you a few different ways you can download your video files from these amazing cards into Sony Vegas and Movie Studio. Just before we jump onto the computer, I'd like to recommend this Kingston card reader for fast transfer of your video files. Just make sure you plug it into the USB 3 port, which are blue in color, and you can download your files super fast. I've been using this for about 12 months and it's great. Let's jump on the computer right now. Okay, so this is going to be a quick one. I've got the SD card connected into the Kingston card reader, which is connected into a USB 3 port. And USB 3 is 10 times faster than USB 2, so that's why you should be using it. So file management is a very personal thing. Everybody has different methods. The method I've been using for the last couple of years is this. I go to your computer or this PC and I find my SD card. I open up the private folder. Now, depending on what format you're recording to, your videos will be located in a slightly different folder. I know mine is in M4 root because I'm recording to Sony XAVC. I go to the clip folder and here's my videos. Then I have a master source video archive folder. And I do it by year, month, and day. And here are all my Zen Tip tutorials. So what I would do is open it up, shrink that down, and then I'm just dragging the files directly into that folder onto my computer. I do all that before I get into Vegas. That's the method I like to use, but it may change, who knows. An alternate method that you can use is use the Device Explorer. That's available in Vegas Pro and Movie Studio Platinum versions. To access it, go to View. Yeah, where are we? Can't see. Window. Device Explorer. There's also a keyboard shortcut of Control, Alt, and 7. Now, it looks like nothing's happening. Don't freak out. Make it a bit bigger. And actually, before I do anything, I'm going to set it up the way it normally looks for most people. So yeah, you right click, no device connected, select browse, go to computer or this PC and find your SD card. And I know mine is removable disk A. So I open that and all I'll need to do is click on top of private. I don't need to go any deeper with this method. Do okay. And Sony Vegas does all the work for me. Now these are all green screen clips, so the beginning of them, you can't see me. To preview them, you can just click on top and it starts playing automatically in the preview window. Probably a better way to do it is to actually do a right click and say open in trimmer. And it's actually importing that one. Oops, it jumped a step a little bit. Anyway, so in the trimmer, That can be a little bit an easier way to scrub through, and then you can say, oh yeah, I want that clip, or I don't want that clip, and so on and so forth. Okay. Now, before you start importing, you want to check something. So we go to device properties, and by default, Sony will create this folder in documents called imported media. If you want that to live on a different drive or in your videos, you want to change that now, okay? Because it needs somewhere, an initial place to import everything. So I'm going to import one more video. Oh, no, there's one already in there. I'm also going to import this one. So you do that, then you're going to bring that into your project onto the timeline. Do your fabulous project, and this is what I recommend you do if you use this method. When it comes to saving as, you go to File, Save As, and let's get out of here. Actually, I'll go right up to here. So say if I create a folder, project one, that'll do. Open that up. Oops, hopeless today, project one. So my veg file is saved. That's what you would normally do. But instead, do an extra thing. Let's go back into Save As. And if you tick Copy Media with Project, then click Save, it's going to create a carbon copy of the video file with your project file. And we want to do the top options, normally the best. So if I now open up my Sony Vegas folder, there's this test project. Let's copy the video in there. Now, the advantage of doing this is that if I then go into the master import folder where everything gets imported, just no matter what it is, I can now, if I wanted to, move these master files into a completely different location on my computer and do some sort of proper organization. But what's going to happen is that then when you reopen your Sony Vegas project, it's not going to say, oh, I can't find the file, because you've made a copy of it in the actual project file. So I hope that makes sense. So that's just a quick alternate method for doing file management with Sony Vegas or Movie Studio. Hopefully that was helpful. And if you've just found me today, have a look just below, right here. There's lots of cool videos in this series that you should check out. There's some really good tips, and I've been getting some good feedback from people saying they want more, they want more, they want more. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you in the next video. See ya.